So imagine you throw a ball. In an ideal world, you actually can predict where your ball falls down, and this process is deterministic. In the other end, if you toss a coin, then you don't know what is happening. There is a 50-50 chance to have heads or tails. This is a completely random process. But the stochastic processes actually sit between these two extreme ends.
Stochastic simulations are simulations that involve a random component. Sometimes the systems that we look at, like the weather or traffic flow issues, are so complicated that it seems like parts of the problem are random. And so we use some randomness in the simulation in order to be able to model what's going to happen in the future. And in that kind of problem, we can really use a lot of memory.
The simulators and the computers that we use, which we call them classical computers, they use a lot of information about the past to be able to predict the future. And they are very wasteful on the information that they save.
What's really exciting about the experiments that we've done here at Griffith University and the collaborative work with our theory friends at National University of Singapore and Nanyang Technological University is that we found a new way to get a quantum advantage, where we've been able to control the states of single photons to encode information for these stochastic simulations and to show the quantum memory advantage.
We have the expertise here in Griffith, which we can produce and control high-dimensional quantum state with such a high quality, which is essential to do this simulation.
It's just a proof of principle or an initial demonstration that the idea works and is powerful. In the future, the idea is to extend this to bigger problems by controlling quantum systems better and better and expanding the size of the problems that we can deal with.